I'm going to be talking about selfishness. Selfishness is putting yourself in the middle instead of others, and yes, it is a way. Selfishness can keep you from knowing God. Tim is a son. Sandra's the mom.
Tim, do you want to go to church with me?
No, Mom, I want to play games all day.
Okay.
Tim, stay there. In that skit, the child chases his games and online friends over God. This is a better way of doing this.
I'm playing games with you guys all day.
Do you
want
to go to church with me?
Yeah, sure. Just let me say bye to my friends. Bye. I gotta go to church.
I'm done. Best for last. Good job, Zach. Good job. Okay, I'm gonna talk about how does fear keep us from knowing the Lord, being known, and making him known. Oh, okay.
Ashley.
My first point.
Ashley.
Yes.
Kyle.
Oh, Kyle. Kyle. Cuckoo! Okay. How does unforgiveness keep us from knowing the Lord? In Webster's 1828 dictionary, unforgiveness means not disposed to overlook or pardon offense. Implacable. Implacable means unable to be pleased. So in Matthew 6:14-15, it says, if you forgive men their trespasses, your heavenly Father will also forgive you. But if you do not forgive men their trespasses, neither will your Father forgive your trespasses. My first point is, you must forgive others for God to forgive you. Now we will do a skit.
Well, you can kiss me. Go away. Why? Because I trusted you. Fine, too. This is so sorry.
She said sorry.
Yeah.
A few hours later.
God, please forgive me for not forgiving Kulea.
No, for you have not forgiven your neighbor.
In this skit, we saw that because Cassandra didn't forgive Kulea, Timothy, acting out to be God, didn't forgive her. Great job, skit team. Okay. My second point is, don't procrastinate on unforgiveness. Now we will do another skit. Let's go to the mall.
Okay.
Oh wait, I forgot my phone.
Let's go get it.
It's not here.
What's
up? Oh, sorry. What is this?
Nothing.
Who's Randy Oval?
Wait, okay, yeah.
Oh, no,
My challenge is that you walk in forgiveness, not unforgiveness. Up next is Ashton, we'll be talking about fear. And pay attention. Okay, now I'm gonna get back to my first point. First point, fear doesn't come from the Lord. In 2 Timothy 1:7, talks about, for God has not given us a spirit of fear, but of power and love and of a sound mind. In 1 John 4:8, it talks about, there is no fear in love, but perfect love casts out fear, because fear involves torment. There is no fear in God's love. Fear comes from not knowing God. God doesn't give us fear because he doesn't want us to hide in a rock. He wants us to be like Pastor Saeed preaching the gospel to Jesus' lost sheep. Come on, where are you guys? Wake up! Can I have an amen?
Amen.
Hallelujah. Second point. What does the Bible say about fear? In Isaiah 41, verse 10, God tells Isaiah, do not fear, for I am with you. Okay, so a quick story. So about 2 weeks ago, Mrs. Hong told us to make a check mark box of what we wanted to do for chapel, and then there was this one section that said, speak. So I put, no way, and then the next day she was like, I had a feeling you were gonna speak, and then, so for that whole entire Bible period, we're listening to the song, No Longer Slaves, and then there was this one verse that spoke out to me, all my fears are drowned in perfect love. So I was like, why would I be scared to speak if Jesus is standing right next to me? Amen. Come on, people. Three. Where does fear come from? Peer pressure. Does anyone know what peer pressure is? You. Yes, young man. You. What is peer pressure? Good job. Two. Embarrassment. Does anyone know what embarrassment is? Not all of them raise their hand. Okay. You. Good job. Three. Scared to preach the gospel. Pretty much self-explanatory, so I get to keep this one. Okay, that's the end. Now we're going to conclude our 6th grade chapel with a human video to the song No Longer Slaves. Oh, 6th grade, take your positions. Woo!
You don't rob me.